गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुसाक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। ॐ सदाशिवसमारम्भाम् शंकराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ओ In this satsanga, we are studying Bhagavad Gita, and after studying the Gita Dhyana, we have just started the first chapter, and so far, we have seen three shlokas. The last shloka was Pashyetam Panduputranam Acharya Mahatim Chamom Vyudham Drupada Putrena Tava Shishyena Dhimata. ओ आचार्य, प्लीज सी दिस माइटी आर्मी ऑफ पांडवास। इट इज वेल अरेंज्ड बाय द्रुपदा, द्रुपदा सन धृष्टद्युम्न, हु इज योर डिसाइपल एंड ऑल्सो He is Dhiman, is very intelligent one. This was the third shloka which we had seen. There, Duryodhana approached Dronacharya and attracted his attention to the army of Pandavas. That is why he is asking to behold Panduputranam Chamum, the army of Panduputras. There is a hidden meaning. That is Panduputranam Acharya, the Acharya of Panduputras. That means you are with us, you are leading a big section of our army, but at the same time, your heart is with Pandavas. And you are in this side. Physically, you are in this side. But mentally, you are with our enemies. That I know. And that is hindered here by calling Panduputranam Acharya. O Acharya, you please see this mighty army of Pandavas. And it is Vyudham. Drupada Putrena. Drupada Putra is here, Drishtadyumna. And who is that Drishtadyumna? He is Dhiman. He's a very intelligent man. Man of intelligence. And he is your disciple. An intelligent disciple will always know the plans and the movements of the teacher. How he will plan, what will be his movements. But everything an intelligent student can perceive. So he knows that. So you must beware of Pandava's movement. That is the meaning. And now Duryodhana is going on to evaluate both the armies. And at the very outset, Duryodhana is evaluating the Pandava army. How it is formed. And let us see that. It begins with the fourth shloka. Atra Shura Maheshwasa Bhimarjuna Samayudhi Yuyudhano Viratascha Drupadascha Maharathaha Dhrishtaketuscha Kitanaha Kashirajascha Viryavan Purujit Kundi Bhojascha Shaibhyascha Narapungavaha Yudhamanyascha Vikranta Uttamaujascha Viryavan Saubhadro Draupadeyascha Sarvayeva Maharathaha. So there are three shlokas beginning with the fourth. And here Duryodhana is evaluating the Pandava army. How it is formed. Let us see. Atra Shura Maheshwasa Bhimarjuna Samayudhi Yuyudhano Viratascha Drupadascha Maharathaha Dhrishtaketuscha Kitanaha Kashirajascha Viryavan Purujit Kundi Bhojascha Shaibhyascha Narapungavaha Yudhamanyascha Vikrantaha Uttamaujascha Viryavan Saubhadro Draupadeyascha Sarvayeva Maharatha. Let us see the words used in these three shlokas. Atra Shuraha Maheshwasaha Bhimarjuna Samaha Yudhi Yuyudhanaha Virataha Cha Drupadaha Cha Maharathaha Dhrishtaketuhu Chekitanaha Kashi Rajaha Cha Viryavan Purujita Kundi Bhojaha Cha Shaibhyaha Cha Narapungavaha Yudhamanyuhu Cha विक्रांतः उत्तमौजाः च वीर्यवान् सौभद्रः द्रौपदेयाः च सर्वे एव महारथाः. अत्र मीन्स् हियर् मीन्स् इन् दि पाण्डव आर्मी, इन् दि आर्मी आफ् पाण्डवास्. अत्र हियर् शूराः फियर्स् फैटर्स् शूराः महेश्वासाः ग्रेट् फैटर्स् ग्रेट् वारियर्स्. द वर्ड् मीनिङ्ग् इस् दोस् हु आर् केरिङ्ग् महेश्वासाः. इश्वास इस् बौ अण्ड् इट् इस् क्वालिफैड् वित् द वर्ड् महा great. And see, Bhimarjuna Samayuthi. Yuthi means in the battle. Yuthi, in the battle. Bhimarjuna Samaha, equal to Bhima and Arjuna. So at the very beginning, Duryodhana says there are many, many warriors who are equal to Bhima and Arjuna. See, when both these Dhartarashtras and Pandavas were learning under Dronacharya, Dronacharya always used to say, Arjuna is the greatest warrior. He is the greatest fighter. And in the case of Bhima, Dronacharya used to say repeatedly, Bhima is great, and in direct fighting, there is no great warrior, or there is no greater warrior than Bhima. So Duryodhana used to hear all this. No need to say, Duryodhana was not happy with those remarks. He was feeling that pain within. And now occasion has come. Because they are in the opposite side. And there are many more warriors. There are many more fighters who are equal to Bhima and Duryodhana, Bhima and Arjuna. So by these words, there is a positive aspect and a negative aspect. The positive aspect is we must be more careful and cautious. And you are the acharya, you are the preceptor, you are the teacher of both the sides, and you are with us. It is our greatness that you are with us. That is the positive aspect. The negative aspect is you taught to all these people without any discrimination, without thinking what will be the future, you taught everybody. And always you are giving good certificate, the best certificate to Bhima and Arjuna. Now we are in a difficult situation because not Bhima and Arjuna, not only they, many, many more are there. And our state is not at all good. So that is the negative aspect. Both these aspects are there. So Atra, here in the army of Pandavas, there are many, many warriors who are equal to Bhima and Arjuna. Bhima Arjuna Samayudhi. And who are they? Yuyudhanaha, Virataha, Drupadaha. And here, especially we have to note that Drupada is qualified as Maharatha. Maharatha. Who is a Maharatha? A fighter who will fight with 10,000 well-equipped warriors, single-handed. Eko dasha sahasrani yodhayed yastu dhanvina shastra shastra pravirnascha sa maharatha udirita. That is the definition of a maharatha. Eko dasha sahasrani yodhayed yastu dhanvina. Ekaha, one single man, who will fight with 10,000 well-armed fighters. And who is an expert in the science and the techniques of warfare. Shastra Shastra Pravirnascha. He is called a Maharatha. So there are many, many Maharathas in the army of Pandavas. That means one Maharatha is equal to 10,000 warriors. So what is meant here? We are 11 Akshauhinis. And they are 7 Akshauhinis. But see, there are many, many Maharathas with them. One Maharatha is equivalent to 10,000 warriors. So there is nothing to boast in the number of our army. There is nothing to boast in that. So we must be that much careful and cautious. So Yuyudhanaha, Virataha, Drupataha. Yudhanaha was a great warrior. Many a time his name and his greatness is explained in Mahabharata. He is also called Satyaki. And Virataha is the king of Virata Rajya. He came with a mighty army. Then Drupada is there. See, Drupada is referred as Maharatha. He is a Maharatha. The only aim Drupada was keeping in mind was how to kill Drona, how to kill Drona. This was the thought which was with Drupada always. Because of the greatness of Drona in the warfare, Drupada cannot win. Drupada cannot fight with Drona. So Drupada was doing many, many austerities, many penances to get a way to kill Drona. And that Drupada's son, Drishtadyumna, himself a great warrior, he came to Dronacharya and Dronacharya accepted him as a student. And he taught all the warfare, all the techniques of fighting. And now he is arranging all, he is arraying the army of Pandavas. See? So here, Duryodhana is naming Drupada and also qualifying him as a Maharatha. That is to bring out that enmity which is there within Drona. If Duryodhana is succeeding in bringing out that enmity, Drona will fight with all his might. So to tap that enmity which is staying there within Drona, Duryodhana is speaking in this touch. If Duryodhana is getting success, having success in bringing out that enmity, Drona will fight with all his might. That is the positive aspect. The negative aspect is, again and again, Duryodhana is giving pain to Dronacharya. It's making Drona remember all these things. See? Then there is Drishtaketuhu, Chekitanaha, then the king of Kashi. And he is a mighty warrior, so it is said, Viryavan. Then Purujit, Kundi Bhojaha. Both are maternal uncles of Pandavas. Then Shaibhyaha. Shaibhya is a great warrior. So he said, Narapungavaha. Narapungavaha, great among men. Then Yudhamanyuhu, Vikrantaha. Who is Yudhamanyu? He is Vikranta, one with mighty steps. Vikranta is one with mighty steps. Uttamaujaha. He is also Viryavan, the mighty one. Then Saubhadraha, the son of Subhadra, Abhimanyu, and Draupadeyaha, five sons of Draupadi. All are Maharathas. All are Maharathas. So here, a question comes. Duryodhana is a king, and in the middle of battlefield, he is praising the army of Pandavas. A king will never do that. Because Sarvayeva Maharathaha, all these fighters, all these warriors, are Maharathas. They are equivalent to 10,000 normal warriors. So Duryodhana is praising the army of Pandava, which a king will never do. Then how and why Duryodhana is speaking so? The reply is, Duryodhana is not talking publicly. Duryodhana is not at all talking publicly. He is talking in secret. Nobody else is hearing. Sanjay is hearing all this because of that boon which Vyasa gave him, because of that special ability to know everything happening in the Kurukshetra. Sanjaya is knowing all these things. So there is nothing wrong with Duryodhana. As he is speaking with his Acharya, who is leading a great section of his army. So there is nothing wrong in that. So that is about the army of Pandavas. As we have seen earlier, we will explain these things from second chapter, because all these shlokas, they are taking us to the study of Gita. If anything is to be explained, you can ask. But we will study in detail from the second chapter, because first chapter is a stepping stone to the Gita studies. So now we will go to the next part, where Duryodhana is evaluating his own army. How is our army? See, asmakam tu visishtaye ta nibodhadvijottama nayaka mama sainyasya samknyartham tan bravimite. Asmakam tu visishtaye ta nibodhadvijottama nayaka mama sainyasya samknyartham tan bravimite. Hey Dvijottama, Dvijottama, best among Dvijas. See? Who is a Dvija? There are many, many meanings. All birds are Dvijas. Birds. And our teeth also is called Dvija. And a Brahmin is called a Dvija. How a Brahmin is a Dvija? Everybody had birth from the womb of mother. We all came from the mother's womb. So that is the first birth. Then, when we are initiated by our Acharya with Gayatri, it is considered our second birth. When we are getting Gayatri from our Acharya, and we are chanting, we are doing Upasana, and it is considered as the second birth. So one who did Upanayana as a mark of accepting Gayatri from a guru, he is called a Dvija, because it is considered as the second birth. So a Dvija is supposed to chant Gayatri, to perform yajnas, to study Vedas, and lead a sattvic life. A Dvija is supposed to be the teacher of Veda. A Dvija will always be calm and will have equanimity within. He will be moving with the light of Veda. All these are the qualities of Dvija. And here, Duryodhana is calling Drona as Dvijottama, best among Dvijas. And how is Dronacharya standing here? He is in the midst of battlefield, not with the Veda in hand, but with a sword, with arrows, with mighty bows. He's a warrior. He's leading a mighty army. And here he is called Dvijottama. That itself will give a negative impact. Because these are not the signs of a Dvijottama. If you are calling him a Kshatriyottama, it is best. He is a Kshatriyottama. He is in the attire of Kshatriyottama. But he is Dvijottama. See? So Duryodhana is calling, hey Dvijottama, asmakam vishishtaha ye tan nibodha. Asmakam vishishtaha ye tan nibodha. Vishishtaha. Vishishtaha, those who are great, those who are prominent, those who are to be specifically mentioned. Such warriors, many are there. Asmakam vishishtaha, ye, those, tan, them, nibodha, you know well. Nibodha means you know well. Ho Acharya, you please know who are the prominent fighters in our army. There are many. Nayakaha mama sainyasya nayakaha. Nayakaha means leaders. Those who are leading mama sainyasya. Mama means my. Sainyasya, of the army. So mama sainyasya nayakaha, leaders of my army. Who are the leaders of my army? You know them. Samknyartham, for your knowledge, tan bravimi, I am explaining, I am telling you. I am telling you who are the leaders of my army. See, here Dronacharya is the teacher of Duryodhana. He is the Acharya. So Duryodhana must have that respect and he must show that respect. He must have that respect within and he must show that respect outside also. That is the tradition. And Drona is leading a great army of Duryodhana. And now Duryodhana is saying, mama sainyasya, of my army, not our army. Plural is not used there. Mama, singular is used. It shows that ego consciousness Duryodhana is having. All of you came and are here as part of my army, not our army. See that? That is the egoism and egotism. It must come out. And always it will come out. Instead of this, this mama sainyasya, if it is asmakam sainyasya, it would have been some more better. It would convey from a higher standpoint. But here he is saying, mama sainyasya nayakaha, leaders of my army. So you don't decide, I am deciding, and you must obey what I am asking you. or what I am ordering. Because you people are my soldiers. Of course, you are leading an army, but you are under me. Mama sainyasya nayakaha. Samknyartham, for your knowledge, bravimi, I am telling, I am speaking. So I am narrating who are the leaders of my army. Who are the leaders? First, Duryodhana is mentioning Bhavan, you are the teacher, that is okay, but now you are a leader of my army. In the hierarchy, I am above you. See, Bhavan Bhishmascha Karnascha Kripascha Samitinjayaha Ashwathama Vikarnascha Saumadattista Dhaivacha Annecha Bahava Shuraha Madarthe Tyakta Jivitaha Nana Shastra Praharanaha Sarve Yuddha Visharadaha. Bhavan Bhishmascha Karnascha Kripascha Samitinjayaha Ashwathama Vikarnascha Saumadattista Dhaivacha. There is another version which says Saumadattir Jayadrathaha. Instead of Tadhaivacha, in some versions, it is the Padha Saumadattir Jayadrathaha. Annecha Bahava Shuraha Madarthe Tyakta Jivitaha Nana Shastra Praharanaha Sarve Yuddha Visharadaha. Bhavan, you. Bhishmahacha and Bhishma. Karnahacha and Karna. Kripascha and Kripa. Who is Kripa? Samitinjayaha. Victorious in battles. Ashwathama, your own son. Vikarnaha, my brother. Saumadattihi, King Saumadatta, or the son of Saumadatta, Saumadattihi. And Annecha Bahava Shuraha. There are many fierce fighters. Bahavaha, many. Who are they? Madarthe Tyakta Jivitaha. Madarthe Tyakta Jivitaha. Madarthe Tyakta Jivitaha. Who have forsaken their life for my sake. Tyakta Jivitaha. They have renounced their lives. They are going to die. I am sure those who are in this army, in my side, they will die. Madarthe Tyakta Jivitaha. So you people who are fighting for me will die. There is no doubt in that. Because you have forsaken your life for me. See the foolishness of Duryodhana. In the battle, no warrior is fighting for somebody else. In those days, when a battle is declared, leaders of both the sides will approach Kshatriyas and invite them. Such and such battle is going to happen. You please come. You join our side. They will invite. And as a part of that dharma, they will come. They will go to that side or this side. So they are not going to serve anybody. It was the dharma of Kshatriya in those days. They will go. But Duryodhana is thinking, all these people have come for me. And those who have come for me have forsaken their life. Their life is gone. Madarthe tyakta jivitaha. Nana shastra praharana. They are experts in using many weapons. Nana shastra praharanaha. Sarve yuddha visharadaha. All are experts in fighting. Yuddha visharadaha. Experts in fighting. So all these warriors are experts. And capable of using many, many weapons. But the fact remains that Madarthe tyakta jivitaha. Those who came for me have forsaken their lives. Their lives are gone. That is the negative meaning. The positive meaning is, with that much dedication, all these people came for me. So they are ready even to die. That is the positive side. With that much dedication, all these people came. Who are they? Bhavan, you. Then Bhishmaha. Then Karnaha. Then Kripacharya. Ashwatthama and Vikarna. Then Saumadati also. First, it is Bhavan, you. You are with me in this side, but your heart is with the Pandavas. Same is the case with Bhishma also. He is fighting in this side, but his mind and heart is with Pandavas. Then Karnaha. Nothing wrong with Karna. Karna is fully dedicated. And Kripacharya, Ashwatthama, he is also fully dedicated to Duryodhana. Then Vikarna. Vikarna is an Atiratha. He's the one among Dhartarashtras. That is one among that 100 children of Dhritarashtra. That is Duryodhana's brother. But at the same time, he never supported the unrighteous activities of Duryodhana. He was an Atiratha, a great warrior. Who is an Atiratha, you know? Atiratha is one fighter who can fight with the thousands of Maharathas. Maharatha himself is one who will fight alone with 10,000 warriors, well-equipped warriors. And one who will fight with many such Maharathas is called Atiratha. So Vikarna was an Atiratha. So that is his greatness. But at the same time, even though he is an Atiratha, he is not always supporting me. For example, when Dushasana was removing the clothes of Panchali, Draupadi, in the court. All the great men were sitting without making even a noise. Bhishma was there. Drona was there. In that assembly, it was Vikarna who shouted, "This is not righteous. We must not do this." It was Vikarna. So Vikarna was not supporting all unrighteous activities of Duryodhana. And here Duryodhana is mentioning the name of Vikarna. See that. So, and there are many, many more various fighters, and all these fighters are that much dedicated. They have readily renounced their lives for me. They have forsaken their lives. And all are experts in warfare. And Yuddha Visharadaha. All are experts in this fighting. So here, Duryodhana, very in the secret talk with his guru, he evaluates both the armies. And after evaluating these two armies, Duryodhana, without any curtain, he is opening up his heart. Great is the army, greater is the army of Pandavas. We are not equal to them. So that we will see in the next shloka. After a break of 2 or 3 weeks, we resumed today, and our Dr. Madhuji gave that notice also, resuming classes. So I thought it is not good to cancel this week also. That is the only reason we took this session. So I think now we will conclude. No question answer session today. In our next sitting, we will do that. Because last many days, that much hectic was the schedule here. Even no rest for 1 minute. That was the schedule for the last 4 or 5 days. And so that much tiredness is there. And so I think we will conclude now. Next week, we can continue. Namaste.
Swamiji, just one comment, if you can do. Today is the 20th anniversary of September 11th, the attacks here in the U.S. And now with all the issues in Afghanistan, just two words on that, Swamiji, if possible.
Today is not only the anniversary of that attack. Even before that, in 1893, Swami Vivekananda ji addressed in the World Parliament of Religions in Chicago this same day. This is the anniversary of that. So today, it is the anniversary of the attack on World Trade Center, and it is the anniversary of Swamiji's great, great talk. And at the finishing part of that lecture, Swamiji said, "Let the bell which opened this assembly be the death knell of all religious bigotry and fanaticism in the world." So that message is still staying. We have to ring that bell and it must be the death knell of religious intolerance. And what we are seeing around, don't go to Afghanistan or Taliban. We need not go there. Just go to the newspaper reports in Malayalam, Kerala. Just go and see the channels, video channels, television channels in Malayalam. And then we will see that Taliban. That Taliban and the ISIS and the Al-Qaeda. All these are brands. All these are different brands. Difference is only in brand name. The liquor is the same. They will market with one brand name in one country and another brand name in another country. And we will think they are fighting in between. No, we are fools. All these are plots of a big drama. And they are working. They have penetrated the Kerala mind, the Indian psyche, and they are working. So instead of saying the anniversary of the World Trade attack, we must say this is the anniversary of Swami Vivekananda's Chicago speech. It was a beginning, and even now it is moving on, and it must move on and on. Don't think that Swamiji has gone. Don't think Swamiji has gone. Swamiji is working through thousands of carriers, messengers. Swamiji had one tongue. Now there are thousands and thousands working all the world around. But the ways through which that religious bigotry is working, that also is assuming many, many faces. So we must spread that message of Swamiji. It is valid even now, and it is powerful enough to penetrate the mind of youngsters, as Toynbee says. It was like an electric shock, irresistible. Even now, we can feel that irresistible electric shock in the words of Swamiji. So spread that. That is our task. Namaste. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah. सर्वे सन्तु निरामयाः सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत् ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः